Welcome, beautiful souls. Today I would like to introduce to you a new race, a new intergalactic race in reality that contributed long time ago to our own DNA, but also to other, she created or co-created other races here in this galaxy. This race is named Arag'Ung and is a reptilian race. So we have reptilian DNA within our own human DNA. So the human DNA, partly, is reptilian DNA. So this race has the origin in the galaxy NGC 3842 in the Leo constellation. In our natal chart is placed at 18 degrees of Virgo. This galaxy is an elliptical galaxy that contains one of the largest black holes known until now. It is estimated that it has a mass of 9.7 billion solar masses, but this is under the point of view of the techniques that are available here on Earth right now. So maybe. So they are reptilian or reptoid, we can say, better said, that can communicate telepathically and vocally. And why I introduce you this race? Because it was yesterday that I was meditating, that all of a sudden a female appeared before me, and after that we chat a little bit, and she shared very interesting information that she wanted explicitly that I shared it with all of you. So I'm here sharing it to all of you. So what else we can say? Well, first of all, here you have a picture of a female of this race. It's very, really similar to the one appeared before me. This picture is taken from the book The Seeders, written by Elena Danan. But every time I read a book like this about galactic races, stellar races, I always follow a rule, as a way of saying. It means that I read about some race and I open my mind to feel the race, its frequency, its consciousness. Sometimes I don't feel anything, but later on, maybe they contact me, other times not. So I only want to share with you races that I've been in contact with, because the other ones, I don't know if they really exist or not. Simply, there's a question mark. So about this race, we can say that they have a beautiful eyes that can see beyond the physical body, beyond the physical world. And their particularity is medicine. a medicine mainly focused on the body, but in reality is a holistic medicine. But for them, the body is very important. Not to be attached to the body. No, it's not about that. It's about because the when we have body, when our soul is incarnated into a body, we can express, manifest our unique creative abilities. We can manifest the purpose that is embedded within our DNA, that without the body is more difficult. That's why the body is very important for them. And they use different kind of techniques to heal the body, or better said, it's not only about healing the body, but realigning, reconnecting the body with the mind and soul, or spirit, we can say. And one of the techniques that for them is very important is breathing. And one of the breathing techniques is breathing through the DNA as a way to keep it clean, awakened and active. They know, for example, that the human DNA has a very important potential, and they want us to awake it fully and use it for our own benefit, in the way as a way of healing ourselves physically, but mentally, to realign us much better with our own soul, but also to get rid of all tyranny, trauma that we have been subjected along the millennia, not only only for the last century, but in reality for millennia. And because of that, they want to be part of the activation of our DNA. And in so at the end of the video, she and a few group of them that are here with us at this moment, will offer to all of us that want, of course, we are free will. Will offer a DNA activation, the part of our DNA that is related to them, of course. So in this way, they will help us to activate the part of us that is connected to our bodies, that feel the importance of our bodies, to keep them healthy, to eat healthy, to stay healthy as much as possible, of course. And in this way, open an inner space to feel, to hear, we can say, the wisdom of our bodies, to feel, to hear the consciousness of our bodies, and in this way be more connected to them, feel them much better, and knowing what is best for them, for our body. So, but without being attached to it. She said, because I don't know if I said it, she was a female. Yes, I said that. She said that it's very important living and feeling consciously our own death as a passage to another dimension, as a way to honor life and all forms of life. And not only death, but even the inner processes of death and rebirth that we can go through while we are evolving, opening our own consciousness. So it's very important living it consciously. And when she shared this information with me, I could feel the love, the light that she was transmitting through this information. It was really nice. For example, they can appear from nowhere, apparently, as it happened to me, because they master interdimensionality. And they work together with some master dragons and Saurian people to see new reptilian races, but also she stressed that they also learn from their errors. For example, if they create a race with too much ego, for example, or particularly violent, they learn not to repeat it anymore. And for example, in this galaxy, they have seeded many races. One is a happy reptilians that live in the Virgo constellation. They are really happy, benevolent, and they spread around the happiness energy. A happiness energy not only for them, because they are happy naturally, but because it's very important for this galaxy to recover the happiness, the energy, the essence of the happiness. Another race that they seeded here is friendly reptilians that are shape-shifting, because for them is very important change, the change. They embrace a change in along their life. So, it's another very important lesson for us, because humans tend to be attached to our past, our memories, and this race, this reptilian race, instead they embrace change, because they know that life is a constant change. And also they are, and these shape-shifting reptilians live in the Corvus constellation. Also, they have seeded more benevolent races in this galaxy. Some are in a primitive stage of evolution, so they are not space-faring, for example. They have different laws and social structures than humans, and they are at the service to others in their particular way, because they help others, but they are not devotees to service to others, to help others constantly. Only when they are called, when they are needed. And for example, at this moment in our own evolution, they stepped forward, presenting themselves to help us to activate our own DNA, the part that is related to them, of course. And they do the same in other races that they have seeded. So they supervise, take care of the races they have contributed to exist. For example, something interesting is that they have a very strong pineal gland. It's not really big, but is strong. It means a strong mind. It means a capacity to go beyond the physical world and see beyond that. And they measure the degree of evolution of a civilization, of a race, for the pineal gland. So for them, we humans are like children, because we have a small, very small pineal gland, and weak, because we have not developed it yet. And she, for example, questioned, but without judging, but she questioned the way we raise our children, because she said, for the West society, you say that children are very important for you, but in reality, you not help them to develop, to activate, develop their own inner abilities, their own inner capacities, extrasensory abilities, for example, but at the contrary, you try to inhibit them or deny them. You put them in schools, but then the schools have some subjects to teach, to learn for the children. They don't allow the children to think for themselves, although apparently maybe yes, but in reality not. And children in this way are not enforced to develop the abilities of their own mind. At the contrary, their mind is sleeping. Is sleeping more and more. Another thing is that we tend to put apart our children with the excuse we have work to do, we have things to do, so we put them apart or go to play, for example, go to watch TV for a while, or we give them a computer, a tablet, for example, but we put them a part of our lives, or most of them. And this is very negative for the children, because since they are very young, it's important for them to be part of the adult life, to contribute, to participate in the adult life, in the way they can, of course, but participate in it as much as possible. Maybe could be cleaning, helping to clean the house, cooking, going shopping for groceries, for example, but or helping something else, but it's very important for them to participate, because otherwise they grow up feeling they are a part of the adult life. So when they finish school or college, for example, it's really a shock for them to enter all of a sudden in the adult life, because they are not trained to do so, for example. So, well, she commented this. As I said, without judging, but focusing in few things that I also think that are very important. And one of them is helping children to develop, to awaken, develop their own inner abilities. As I said, the Arag'Ung contributed to our own DNA, and that's why the reptilian from Draco, that we can say they are very malevolent, dominant, they only want to conquer walls, yes, of course, but they felt at that moment, centuries, millennia ago, in reality, they felt attracted to us as humans here on Earth, because they didn't know why, but they felt that an attraction of some kind, because we have a part of our reptilian DNA that resonated or resonates with their own. Although they have taken a very, we can say, controversial path, a very difficult path, they are really disaligned or completely disaligned from the source, from the primordial source. So, well, but at the beginning, not at the beginning, but they have also a reptilian DNA that is within or resonates with our own. And well, and now, if you want, of course, you can decide now, or maybe later, another day, you can watch another time this video. So now you can decide if you want to receive an activation of your DNA, of our DNA, in reality, the part that is related to them, or they contributed to us, to our own DNA. If you want to receive it, then now we can start the activation. For that, we can close our eyes. Breathe in and out slowly, deeply. Now we can place one hand or both of them over our heart to feel it, to feel its rhythm. It ceaselessly beat. To feel its energy, to feel its cells, how they beat constantly, how they are alive. And each one of them has DNA. And now we invoke an Arag'Ung allowing her or him to activate our own DNA, the part of our DNA that is related to them. And we open ourselves to receive the activation. Maybe we feel a sudden electrical current along our spinal cord, or maybe a subtle heat along the spinal cord, or maybe we don't feel anything at all. But it doesn't mean the activation is not taking place, because it's happening. And once we feel that it's enough, that it finished, we thank the being that was assisting us to activate our DNA, and then little by little we can breathe deeply and open our eyes. And that's all for today. Have a luminous and lovely day. See you soon.